What's going on, everyone? My name is Wade Patterson, and you did it. You made it to video number 8 in my 8-part series on how to launch a podcast. If this is your first video as part of this series, make sure you go and check out the previous videos. Video number 1, I said why you should launch a podcast, the benefit you get from doing so. In video number 2, I talked about some of the prep work you want to do before jumping into the process of launching a podcast. In the 3rd video, I talked about what equipment you need to launch a podcast. The 4th video was all about how to create a great script, whether you're interviewing somebody or even the script for yourself, what you're going to talk about. The 5th video was how you can reach out to interview guests or potential interview guests and pitch them and what things to say in that circumstance. The 6th video in the series was all about what to do during the interview and how to prep your guests for an interview or a podcast episode. And the last video prior to this one was all about editing your audio and some of the things to consider when using Adobe Audition. And this is the final video, and you've done it. You've created the podcast, you came up with the concept, you got everything done, you got your intro done, you got all of those steps, and now you have your final MP3 file that is the culmination of an edited podcast, and you're wondering what to do with it. Well, you need to syndicate it. You need to get it on all of those cool apps like Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Pocket Cast. Again, like so many things I talk about in this series, there are multiple options. There are syndication services that are out there that are different, that offer different features. I am talking to you about what I have experience of. And as I mentioned in previous episodes, I've launched 2 podcasts in the last 2 years. One is the Remax Hustle podcast, which is all about interviewing real estate agents and brokers and telling their stories. And then the other kind of passion project I've done is a YouTube interview show called Show Me the Crypto, where it's a YouTube interview series, but we take the audio and we turn it into a podcast. In both of those instances, what I use for syndication is a service called Anchor, anchor.fm. And for my money, I don't think that there is a better service out there. I could be wrong. Feel free to comment below. Let me know what is better that is out there. But Anchor is such a powerful service. It is free to use. Setting up a profile is as easy as setting up any social media profile. You add your episode logo, you add your description, you add your title. And within days or weeks, it is already syndicating. Once you launch that first episode, it's syndicating to Spotify, it's syndicating to Apple Podcasts. And that's one of the most rewarding things, is once you're able to put out an episode, actually seeing that on your phone, like you can search for your podcast and it comes up on Spotify, that's pretty cool. It's a cool feeling. I hope all of you experience that as you take this journey into launching a podcast. But Anchor is great for all of those reasons. When you go to upload a podcast, the process is very simple. You are simply dragging the audio in. You are giving your episode an episode title. You might give it a description, which I encourage you to do. Tell the audience who you're interviewing or what that episode is about, what they can expect. And that's pretty much it. You upload it and boom, within minutes, and I mean it, minutes, your podcast is not only available on the Anchor website, but also through Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and Pocket Cast, Google Podcasts, like all of those. I think there's 8 different sources that it syndicates it out to. Super powerful. Another thing I love about Anchor is the analytics it gives you. So it tells you who is listening to your podcast, what their age demographics are, whether they are male or female, majority, it gives you percentages, what countries and even what provinces and cities those listeners are coming from, all sorts of analytics that really helps you understand what episodes were attractive to the audience and did well in terms of listens, what episodes were listened by certain areas. And all of this can help you with future episodes, because data is your friend. And when you have that information, you can really plan out from there. So uploading a podcast through Anchor or whatever service you're using is a great step, but you're not done there, because just because you've uploaded your podcast and you know where it is on Spotify or Apple Podcasts, your audience probably doesn't. So you need to make sure and inform them of where they can find this episode. And this is where it's a great idea to have some episode art or a photo of the individual you've interviewed. Maybe you create a graphic on Canva or WordSwag or something along those lines, where it's an image that you can then share out on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. Maybe you make a square image and then you make a vertical image, a story-sized image, so you can share it through Instagram stories, Facebook stories, LinkedIn stories, all of those platforms. You have different pieces of content, but you're letting your audience know, hey, there's a brand new episode that is out. Make sure you check out this episode. And that's why it's important, and I talked about this in earlier videos, that you want to also have a call to action to have your audience subscribe to the podcast so that you don't have to be the one always informing them. If they subscribe on Spotify, every time you launch a new episode, it's going to pop right up on their phone. They will be notified of that. And that is what you want. You want your audience to be engaged, to be looking forward to future episodes that you're going to put out. Another thing you can do, especially if you're incorporating video, is you can take little bite-sized clips from the interview and you can share those through social media as well. This is something we do with my podcast, Show Me the Crypto, pretty often. We take 3 clips from every episode and we do 1 minute or shorter videos and then share that even on TikTok and Instagram and various platforms to, again, give the audience a little taste of what the interview's like. If you're choosing to do a podcast that's audio only, you can still do a photo with like the sound waves, create a graphic like that through Canva, and you can still share that type of content through something like Instagram or Facebook. Again, these are ways of giving your audience that little impression of why they want to go and then download the full episode later on. I really hope this 8-part video series on how to launch a podcast has been beneficial to you. If you haven't checked out the previous videos, go do that. If you're thinking that this has added some value to your life, here's what I ask of you. Subscribe to my channel, turn on that notifications bell, and engage with future content, because just like you, I'm really excited to be putting out more content, and I want to grow my audience, and I want to help make everyone more impactful and effective communicators. And by subscribing to my channel, you'll help me do just that. Stay tuned. I plan to do more of these 8-part series throughout the year of 2021. It's my New Year's resolution, so hold me accountable to that. Otherwise, hope you enjoyed this. And I'll look forward to seeing you on the next video.